Hey guys, Prince of Macedon here, and I'm joined by none other than Patchy himself.
That's right. Coming straight from the Chaos Waste.
He is straight from there, guys. And we're going to do a lot of testing out of crap. And as soon as I figure out how to do this, alright, hold on.
Game up. I made a slot for you there.
No, I see it.
Sweet. Should we try out one of these crazy new maps, too?
Yeah.
Is it going to be too, like, wild looking?
Let's do it.
Didn't they make, like, forest? Like, underground, like, forest? What did they call it? Beastway?
I missed all the trailers and stuff. And all
Here it is. Great Forest, Heart of the Dark.
So, basically what me and Eric are going to do, we're going to test out different things like Malagor versus Mannfred, or Malagor versus Franz, all kinds of cool things.
So, how do we want to test? You want to start off against von Carstein?
Let's do it. Just Malagor versus von Carstein?
Do you want to go like no abilities, no spells?
I think we should give them all their spells.
All spells, all abilities. Like, what about mounts? Like, on the ground, or what do you want to do?
Put them on their mount, because that's probably what they're going to encounter online.
You think best mount?
Yeah. And okay. I'm going to give Malagor his, this item. It's called Icons of Vilification. Not sure what that'll
Holy
do.
Holy crap, man. When you get von Carstein mounted up with all of his spells, he's, and you can even put the Sword of Unholy Power on him. 3,655.
Holy smokes. My guy, Malagor, is 2,339.
Because he has, like, all the vampire spells and all of the death spells.
Yeah. Crap. All right, so, let's see. So, yeah, I'm going to...
So it's no rules? Straight brawl?
Yes, a straight-up brawl, and then we'll just see how well they do.
Okay.
Yes, straight-up brawl. But, yeah, you can use spells. You can use Spirit Leech, whatever you want.
Let's see how it rolls.
All right.
I'm ready.
So yeah, we're talking about spawning a Saigor with Malagor. I might try it. I'm not sure if that'll do any good against Mannfred, though.
It might not hurt.
Yeah. I think I'll spawn him out.
Have the Saigor crush his skull?
Yeah. I'm going to throw some boulders at you, man. Boulder dash.
It'd be kind of funny if the Saigor reached into the ground and pulled out like a corpse and threw it at him.
Yeah. Hey, give me one sec. I want to show some close-ups of Malagor.
Sure.
Now, you would think with these wings he could fly, but I don't think he can fly.
It's kind of like a dodo.
Yeah. Freaking ostrich. Let me turn on my thing here.
Snap's pretty cool. Like, won't be a lot of outflanking, but it's kind of a cool ambiance here.
That is pretty cool. Oh, that is really awesome, actually. Looks like we're... This is like where the Avalon people live. Not Avalon, Avatar.
Man, it's like some weird pulsating fungus on some of the big trees.
I think Nurgle's left his impressions here.
Apparently.
Okay, let me look at my spells really quick, so make sure I can catch them all. Alright. There's really pretty good spell here. Let me see if I can find it.
I think we all know the one spell that von Karstein's going to be leaning towards.
Yeah, and we already agreed to use any spell so we can test out their full abilities. So, yeah.
Let's
I can't
see.
Find it.
Should I use Spirit Leech or Spirit Leech?
Hold on, I can't find that. There is a direct damage spell that he has. I can't find it.
Does he have multiple lures or just one?
It looks like just one. Yeah, it's just one. Hold on. Okay,
Beastmen should have had Lure of Manure.
What is crap on him?
Yes, like... Crap Comet of Cassandora.
Yeah. Oh, shoot. This direct damage thing, it only affects ground, I think. I'm not sure. It says ground enemy affects enemies in range 200 meters. I don't know if that'll affect the air units.
No idea. I'm going to have to come down and attack you or else I'll lose all my leadership, though, since I'm flying.
Oh, that's true. All right. I'm ready when you are.
Let's do this.
Let's do it. Alright, so Error's over there with Mannfred. So, you know what I'm going to do, guys? Oh, I can do it right now. I can spawn my Saigor, which I'm going to do.
See if that equal or evens the odds.
Let's do it. Here we go.
Let's watch what it does to the power meter.
Yeah, we'll see what happens. Alright, he's... Can you see my guy?
Yep. Watch this.
Here he comes. Thriller!
Yeah, there we go.
Oh, yeah. Look at that bounce bar. I now have two units. Let me hotkey him. I get ready for the anti-air capabilities.
Your boulder means nothing.
Let's see what happens.
My zombie dragon eats boulders for breakfast.
Oh, here he goes. He's winding up.
Strike.
Let me try this traitorkin once you start engaging me. I'm going to move my guy around to get away from you.
Oh, I got to get down and attack. My guy's starting to lose leadership.
Oh, crap. Save me, Sigor.
Spirit Legion.
All right. Traitorkin.
Got to get the cheese leech out.
Yeah, man. Dude, my Sigor's not moving. Move, Sigor. Crap. Problem is my general's about to bite it. Let's get out of here. I can launch it again.
Big rock smashing.
Keep doing it, Sigor. Crap. Problem is Malagor is about to bite it.
That's a pretty decent weapon damage, Sigor.
Yeah, I know. Hopefully that'll buy time for Malagor to come back. Control over him. All right, here we go.
They increased the time on Spirit Leech.
Did they?
I don't know. I'm about to look.
I didn't notice.
Eh, it's only 13 seconds.
Get out of there, Malagor. No, Malagor, no!
Oh man, get down, von Carstein, you're about to crumble.
Gotta do the alternate attack. Hope I get Malagor back so I can cast another Traitorkin on you. That Traitorkin's pretty rough.
Did it work?
I think so.
I didn't see what was coming, causing the damage, whether it was the Sigor or not. Should've been paying attention.
Yeah, some of it came from my direct spell.
That is a big rock to the face.
Yeah.
Hey, were you saying you wanted him back?
What's that? Yeah, he's... I lost control over him.
Spirit Leech.
Do it! Did it do anything to him?
Third time's the charm here, Sigor.
Get him, Sigor! Oh! That was pretty close.
Yeah, I tell you what, though. The Sigor actually really did make that a lot more difficult.
Yeah, a lot more
difficult. Monster like that you can use to keep someone away. But
can we switch that matchup? Because I think maybe I didn't do so well.
You want me to try it?
Yeah, I want you to try it.
Okay, all right.
Because I think I could have evaded you better with Malagor.
Malagor? Is that his name?
I think so, yeah. Because I feel like if I would have evaded your charge better, I could have kept my guy alive longer.
Sounds like the planet off that Star Wars game.
Oh, yeah. What are they called?
Malagor?
Malagor?
Yeah, sure enough. Malagor the Dark Omen. All right. So you stuck everything on him, like deck him out?
Yeah, everything on there. And I even added Swarm of Flies to my guy.
All right. We'll do. Yeah, I mean, I had like the decked out von Carstein, like the pimp my von Carstein version.
Pimp your Carstein. All right, yeah, I got mine. He's 3655. All right, let's try this. So I'm going to try to go right for your commander and try to just ignore Sigor.
All right, see what we can do.
Yeah. And I will be using Spirit Leech as hell.
Who doesn't?
Who doesn't do that, guys?
It is ridiculous in playing the vampire campaign. It's like you go into the battle and it's like the very first thing you do is just Spirit Leech the enemy general. It's just like it's over.
It's a scientific formula.
Yeah, you'd have like 3 or 4 Terror Geist and Spirit Leech and it's like every army just turns and runs immediately.
What do you think? Should I bother with the Gaze of Nagash? Or just go right for Spirit Leech?
I don't know. Does Gaze of does it have... Well, it doesn't... So, Malagor doesn't have much armor, so I think the Gaze of Nagash would tear him up pretty bad if it hit him.
I'll try it. I'll see what happens.
He's only got 15 armor. Like, he's gonna get jacked if he gets hit by it.
All right. We'll try that. I am ready.
You ready?
You are. Yeah.
All right. Let's do it.
Oh, by the way, for Sigor, your default attack is his range attack.
Yeah. Saw that.
See if I can rush her before he spawns
here
out.
He
no, probably not. Alright, there's Air's little beast. Jesus Christ.
You know what would be kind of funny looking after seeing this is if they made, like, another one that was a bunch of little mini Sigors, like, hurling, like, pebbles and stuff.
Oh, that'd be awesome. Like, Sigor could spawn his own.
That'd Did he amazing. Throw that rock from that far away?
He had the
Dude,
option.
He's got some range.
Yeah, I'm trying to evade it, see what happens.
This is like a chaos version of Nolan Ryan or something.
Holy shit, holy cow, here it comes. Oh, okay.
Wow. Yeah, you can evade it, it looks like.
Yeah. But it's cool that you got the range. He's like an artillery piece.
Yeah, he is, man. 356 range, that's like, I think only a cannon's gonna go further.
Oh crap, I think he hit me with a boulder here.
Oh, did the boulder hit a tree?
It might have. I think I missed you. I just missed you, didn't I?
Hey, way to aim, Von Carstein. Watch your leadership. It's going down because there's no land or ground units.
Yeah, I probably should land. But let's go right for your commander.
Oh, that one got you.
Holy cow. All right, let's do my
decent
spirit.
Hit.
All right, I'm spirit leeching his commander before I land. All right, let's get down here. Oh, dude, not to him! What is he doing? That's the wrong target.
Just got a kind of fun stuff to try to direct damage, though.
Alright, so I'm basically trying to ignore Sigor, because I don't think I can... If I kill Malagor, I might have a good chance.
What's we got here? Try some more nonsense.
Oh crap, my guy's starting to break, as you can see.
Big magic explosion.
What was that?
It was a big magic explosion.
Yeah, that was... What the hell was that?
I don't know. Raider kid. Trying to find some other fun stuff.
I think Karthus is going to bite it this time.
I'm going to try a spell that increases the attack on my Sigor.
Do it. Oh no! Oh, he's gone. Dang it.
So what would you prefer if you're in an online battle? Do you prefer having the giant, like, summon monster, or would you rather just have the spirit leech?
Oh, man, it's hard. Like, in a straight-up battle between armies, I think the giant monster might be more effective.
Yeah, seems like you could really, like, jack up someone's strategy if all of a sudden a giant monster's crawling out of the ground.
Exactly. And I feel like once I spawned it out, you know, I wouldn't mind if I lost... Malagor.
So I guess that one just depends on how they use their lord there if you're trying to go head-to-head.
Exactly. Can we do two more matchups with the same matchup?
You want the same matchup?
Yeah, just like two more times and then we'll switch it up.
Sure. You want to go back to Beastmen or are you going to stick on Vampires?
Yeah, I'll go back to Beastmen. I think it's an interesting matchup.
Zombie Dragon.
I think Aaron's a little bit better at using these lords than myself.
I'm going to pimp the Von Carstein out here.
Tip it out, man.
We need the swarm of flies.
I'm
how
sure
can
that
you be undead
like...
without a swarm of flies?
What's that?
I said, how can you be undead without a swarm of flies?
Exactly. I feel like that'd be like an automatic thing. Like a passive spell. Alright, I'm ready when you are.
They should add another category called like entourage down there. You know, and then like Von Carstein can have a couple of vampire ladies with him, you know?
Oh, yeah. Esmeralda or whatever
that
girl's name is.
They can ride around in like a little black coach. It's like Von Carstein and the entourage.
You know, back in the day when they first made those miniatures, some of those vampire lords looked like rock stars.
Oh yeah? Yeah, it was like Kiss or something?
Yeah! Yeah, look up Vlad Von Carstein. Like his first model. Ridiculous.
Gene Simmons Von Carstein.
Yeah, pretty much.
All right. Ooh, I started with less magic this time, so did you. See, you have to wait for the charge up on your
Sigor.
Yeah. I'll have a chance to rush here.
All right. Well, I'm gonna corner camp back here so I can charge more. All right. I'm ready when you are. And bring your worst. Let's see how long I have. Where's it at? Oh crap, man.
Dude, how cool would it be if someone made a mod that made a bunch of, like, Rome units and medieval units and combined it with Warhammer, and it was just, like, an all-star Total War thing where you could just have, like, all kinds of nonsense going on.
That would be amazing. Kind of like Arena, I guess.
Yeah, that'd be... I still was trying to tell Creative Assembly they should make Arena, like, multi... Like, they should have, like, Arena in different time periods and then, like, the crazy, like, just every time period, like, all at once. So it's, like, Genghis Khan running around with Napoleon and, like, everything in between.
That would be awesome. You have, like, a freaking cuirassier taking on, like, a medieval knight. I'd love to see that. Uh-oh, guess who has time to spawn?
Oh, he's got the winds of magic now.
Yeah, I basically hid him. All right, there's errors. Von Cheestein there. It's gonna be the battle of the...
Dude, he's packing all kinds of moldy undead cheese.
Right, I'm gonna keep my god moving here. Swing, bada, bada, swing, bada, bada, swing, bada.
That's a pretty good hit.
Yeah.
See?
I'm just gonna hide out near my command, near my Sagora.
Invocation of the heck.
Oh god, here it comes, guys.
That rock's right. Nothing I can't heal.
Alright, I'm gonna use the old traitor kin here.
Oh, missed.
Take that, traitor.
I was trying to see what happens if I don't spirit leech, so I was trying to like...
Would you try to use Nagash?
Yeah, I used Nagash, but then I used Invocation of the heck a minute ago.
Oh, okay. Did it heal you up pretty good?
Yeah, it did. It healed the rock damage there. Alright, looks like I'm gonna have to get this Sigor out of my way.
While you're doing that, I'm gonna try to dance around and try to... I have to wait 47 seconds to use Traitorkin again. What other spells can I use? Explosion. I feel like I'm gonna hurt my own guy if I do that.
Is it just me or am I kind of glad that the Invocation of the heck has a longer cooldown than Spirit Leech, or things might really just crazy with vampires?
Yeah. Yeah, I think the healing thing is kind of... It can be abused pretty much.
Did you ever try out the Vampire Death Star?
No, I saw your video on it, though. That was a great video.
Yeah, we found out that if you use Wraiths, though, the Foot of Gork, like, annihilates Wraiths. Like, it'll just... It stomps them out. Like, it doesn't work on anything else, but, like, on Hex Wraiths or regular Wraiths, like, if you let them get blobbed up in combat, use Foot of Gork, Green Skin, I mean, it just completely destroys the Wraith unit.
Oh, wow. I have to look at that. You made a video for that, or...?
Say what?
Did you make a video for that?
Yeah, I did, man. Like, it's insane. Like, one stomp from the Foot of Gorth, and I killed 110 Wraiths once.
God, wow, that's crazy. I'll have to try that.
Like I said, it doesn't work on anything else. Like, the Foot of Gorth's crappy versus everything else, but against the ethereal units, like, it completely destroys them.
Oh my gosh. Alright, I'm gonna use a multiple thing here. I don't know if it's gonna work or not. It's... Devolve. But it's only good for multiple units. I don't think it's gonna affect you that much. Nah, they didn't do anything. Oh, did you just heal yourself?
Yeah, I'm healing myself over and over again. I've still got a ton of winds of magic, too.
Crap. Yeah.
Von Karstein's gonna hit point sponge his way through this.
I think so. Oh, crap. Well, Malagor's gonna bite at them without his best buddy here. Oh, crap.
Oh.
Run, Malagor. Fly.
Hold on. Eat the Sigor. Eat it.
Run. Oh, he gets up.
Bite that Sigor. Bite it.
Come on, Sigor. Come on. Life is still good.
Oh, here. I got something for your Sigor here.
Oh, come on. Let's see.
Oh, yeah. There we go.
Man.
Oh, I cast a wind spell and I did it completely wrong. Look at it going the other direction.
Oh, look. I'm trying to root where away. Okay, I can cast my traitor. Traitor! Cast it. Let's see.
What?
What happened?
I don't know. He was supposed to do the gaze of Nagash, and I don't think he did.
Maybe I was too close with him.
I don't know what happened.
That was weird. You're like, what? Oh, I think Malagor's gonna bite it here. Wait, well, he's gonna bite it.
Here we go. What else do I have up the old vampire toolkit here?
He's gonna Von Cheese me here, guys. Watch out.
I got lots of options. I mean, Spirit Cheese is fun.
Do it.
I wanted to go gaze in the gash, but it ruined it. Alright, let's just go bite him.
Try it. And try to dance around it. No.
It's like flying units, like Carl Franz, man. He has some aim problems sometimes when he's charging down out of the sky.
Yeah, I've noticed that. Like, I feel like it's better not to even chase down, like, routed units with Carl, because he'll just miss him. Oh, Malagor bites it.
So, the invocation of the heck, man, that's some good stuff.
That is some good stuff. All right, we'll do one more time, same matchup.
All right,
and then we'll branch out a bit more.
All right, here we go. All right, I'll switch over.
All right, gonna pimp my Karstein out.
Malagor.
Give myself some more flies. And give myself this freaking sword of the unholy power.
The only thing I wish they would add, like, so, I mean, I'm definitely, like, into, like, testing what they added here. I think it'd be cool if they would have taken it a step further and, like, a standard unit had, like, banners and stuff you could purchase for it. Like, that would be cool.
Yeah, that would be cool. Like, even, like, customize.
Yeah, like, that way, like, if you're worried your Demigrip Knights are going to get Fate of Unit, maybe there's, like, a banner that gives you, like, 10 or 15% magical resistance or something.
Now, that would be cool. Like a certain amount of funds you can allocate.
Yeah.
Towards that. That'd be pretty awesome. Yeah, I'd definitely protect my elite units. Care, like, some holy water or something.
Yeah, there'd be some cool stuff they could throw in there, I think. So, I mean, this is a good start. Like I said, I have no idea how it's going to turn out. It may make things worse, but I think it's the right idea. Maybe it just, you know, if it's unbalanced, just fix that, but I like the idea.
Yeah, exactly. So, it's definitely to add more stuff is always awesome.
Yeah. And then just free-for-all. Like, this game screams for free-for-all.
Oh, hell yeah. Yeah, I think everyone who has a voice should always, you know, badger them about free-for-all.
Free-for-all would be amazing. And then, like, a variant of free-for-all that I don't know how you'd make it work exactly, but I was thinking, like, King of the Hill, maybe? Or, like a capture point thing where there's certain capture points on the map, and whoever wins is the one who gets, like, the most time in the capture points or something. Like, I don't know. Like, I'm just trying to think of, like, some other ideas you could add to...
Oh, yeah. Kind of like Shogun 2's capture, I guess.
Like, where you had the key buildings.
Yeah. All right, I am ready. All right. I'm going to try to charge you. And let's see if you can spawn out your beast in time.
Looks like I'm almost there. 16 magic?
16? Yeah.
That's how much you need. Looks like the power reserve's bigger than it used to be.
I didn't even notice it.
I think it used to be 60, and now it says 70 on here.
Yeah, I think you're right.
I wonder if that's only when you choose a legendary lord, or if it applies, because that was another thing people had suggested, is like the legendary lords who were wizards were kind of pointless because their spells weren't more powerful.
Yeah.
So some people were saying maybe a way to balance it would be to give them like a whole lot more magic reserve so that it's that way they get to actually like do more spells.
Oh yeah, to make it more, I guess, legendary.
Yeah. Like otherwise it's like, why would you bring Balthazar? Like, who cares?
Yeah, I think I used Balthazar like once in my life, and he died. I was pretty upset.
His metal face doesn't resist as much damage as you would hope.
Exactly. I think beneath that metal exterior there lies a fragile man.
Yeah, a soft and disturbed fragile man.
Yes.
Carl Franz picked on him in school.
I think so. Alright, there's that
freaking... Was it a science experiment where he threw a bunch of metal and it got stuck to his face?
Beneath the phantom.
High school. Is Spirit Leech kind of like a bad sunburn?
I'm not really sure what that is. I'd like to see the story behind it. But I do have my codex. I can look it up. And funny, what exactly?
You got a codex, huh?
Yeah. Maybe just like a close-up illustration of it.
I like the equivalent of Caesar's Gallic Wars for the Old World.
Oh, I wish it was. That'd be awesome. Like, all in the third person. I'm going to cheese my... Or he is going to cheese his opponents now. With some invocation. Let's see.
Whoops. Hey, check it out, I missed.
Oh, nice! What was that?
It was an explosion spell. I thought I could click it on your character, like, so I was clicking his banner, but it just clicked it on the ground behind the banner.
Oh, man.
Whoops.
Holy cow. Get him. Get to the Malagors. Let's try Spirit
Reach. And it's probably a good thing they limited the spawning of Cygors to one.
Yeah, that would be super abusive. Like, imagine if you lost him and you just get him right back.
I mean, that could get pretty bad.
Yeah, oh no! Move!
We got here Devolve. Which one did I use a minute ago? I used Traitorkin.
Alright, finally I got my Halo.
Was Devolve any good?
What's that?
Yeah,
it is pretty good when I'm on the ground. I'm not sure if it affects the air. You can try it.
Let's find out.
I'm gonna try to heal up my dude here a little bit. Just because he can.
Looks like a huge area spell, so it's probably only good for like damaging all the units in an army or something.
Let me try some Nagash here. Yeah, I think it's just an area spell. Huh. Oh, man!
That's a pretty solid hit.
Alright, I'm gonna get my healing ready this time. I didn't get to use my healing last time.
If you use the healing, it'll probably do it.
Yeah. Alright, let's make sure this guy dies here. No, he keeps wanting to fight that Saigor.
What if the Saigor missed you with the rock and then took out Malagor?
I wonder if that's possible. Which is like
that'd be hilarious.
Like friendly fire?
Saigor is like, whoops.
Sorry, Master. Alright. Let's see if that helps.
I still think it would be appropriate if he was throwing a giant ball of manure.
That would be freaking awesome. Right, I'm gonna try Nagash on your Saigor, see what happens.
He has 50 armor, so not great armor.
Hey, you'd think he'd be like super buff.
Like how he gets ready to throw the rock and he's like, you hear me?
I'm back. It crashed for a second.
Guy. Man, I can't. Throwing rocks at you.
Yeah. There you go. Oh, but I hit the wrong thing, didn't I? Oh, whatever. Alright, I'm gonna try to land.
Pretty sure von Karstein's gonna be able to easily take out the Saigor here, especially with the heck.
We shall see.
You gotta see how cool it looks whenever he takes that rock and like splatters like 30 swordsmen. It's pretty good.
Oh, we can check that out. All right.
Let's make an empire jelly.
Yeah. Empire sandwich.
So I'm thinking von Karstein's definitely holding that edge.
Yeah, I think he does.
No one's knocking him up on top sorcerer.
Yeah, I mean for that cost though, yeah, I think that's pretty justified.
Well, yeah, I mean he costs like what 1,200 more or something. It's yeah. Ridiculous.
All right. What other kind of matchups can we do here? You want to do Carl? See how he does?
Take Carl against Khazrak the One-eye?
Yeah, we could try that.
And pimped out mode?
Yeah, let's pimp it out.
See, I don't think his chariot's going to bode well.
Interesting. Oh, by the way, we're playing like a beta build, and Baltazar costs more money than Carl Franz here.
Yeah, we'll see how that flies.
Yeah. Unless,
I think Balthasar is going to be a permanent backbencher with that going on.
I think so. Unless they get something really awesome. Let me see.
I haven't checked to see if they buffed any spells, though.
I don't know.
Like, if they buffed, like, bombardment spells or something like that, then all of a sudden, you know, it might change that. But, like, all the wizards cost a lot more now.
Oh, do they really?
Yeah. It's like a light wizard was, like, 800, and now it's, like, 1,200 before you even get the Pegasus.
Oh, hold on. I'll be right back. Give me 1 second, okay?
Sounds good.
Hey, I'm back.
Hey.
Sorry about that.
Dude, Minotaurs with great weapons, 76 armor piercing damage, and a 24 bonus versus large.
Jeez. Let me check him out real quick.
And they don't have hardly any armor, but I'm guessing that they're going to be pummeling. Like, there's 9 of them, so it's kind of like a Cryptor type group of Minotaurs.
Oh, hell yeah. Minotaurs.
Minotaur, whatever.
Yeah, yeah. Whatever it's called. Yeah, it's cool that they have a lot of access to the same units of Chaos. But I think back in the old days, they were all one faction, I think.
Was it?
I believe so.
The Beastmen wanted their independence?
I guess so. We're too beastly for this.
They didn't like Archaon's tyranny?
I don't think they did. They didn't like Siegfald's...
He was too magnificent.
I think so. His legs. His length.
He was making everybody feel bad when he worked out at the gym.
Exactly. We feel inadequate when we're in the presence of Siegfald.
Am I the only one that feels like Siegfald is magnificently disappointing?
Oh, no, I think so, too. However, I was looking at his thing. They gave, like...
Did they add some good stuff for him?
I'm not sure. It says Auric Armor, and it says it regenerates... Hold on, let's go look at that. If you look at his...
Dude, they added Everwatcher. Awesome.
Where?
The giant demon with the wings.
Hold on. Looking for it? Wait, are we looking at Chaos?
Yeah, yeah, look at Chaos, like on the Lords. They added Sarthorael or whatever, the Everwatcher. Probably butchered his name, but that's what he gets.
Hold on. I'm like, not seeing this right now.
Replenishes hit points of combatants. So that's that Auric armor kind of makes that like Von Karstein, where I think that when they're fighting, they're replenishing some hit points.
That would be cool, but like, yeah, in the lore, yeah, Sigfall does have regenerative abilities. Let's see. Yeah, Auric armor. Wait, where did you find that? I can't find it. What you're talking about? The
item?
Yeah, the flying thing.
Oh, go up to the Lords,
yeah.
Like all the way just to the left of Archaon. He's already been in the campaign, but it looks like they're making him playable here.
Was it Kolek?
No, it's to the right of Kolek.
Hold on. Wait, do I not have the same screen as you?
That's what I'm wondering.
I see Archaon, and then I see Kolek.
They're like right next to each other?
Yeah.
Dude, I got extra DLC.
How'd you do that, man?
I don't know, but I got Sarthorael the Everwatcher. You know, like the big bird dude that they showed off in one of their videos?
Yeah. What the hell?
You don't have him?
I don't. unless I'm blind here. See, I have, for my legendary lords, I have Archaon, Kolek, Chaos Sorcerer, another Chaos Sorcerer, another Chaos Sorcerer, Fire, Ziegfeld, and Chaos Lord.
Dude, you're getting screwed.
Yeah, dude. Man, CA screwed me over, man. What happened?
What the heck? I don't even know what's going on.
Hey, do you want to try to bring him?
Yeah, I can bring him.
All right.
Who do we want to go head-to-head with?
I don't know. Is he more of a melee or a spellcaster?
He's a spellcaster.
All right, well, I'll bring this guy then, Malagor again.
Should we take him head-to-head with Malagor?
Yeah,
dude, got some cool abilities.
Does it seem like he can stack up against the Saigor?
He's got one that takes like 90 seconds off of ability recharge.
Oh, that would suck.
So like he can use his abilities 90 seconds faster?
Yeah. That'd be like...
Oculus.
Yeah, that's kind of like a finesse spell.
He's Lore of Metal. So he's like Balthasar except big and cool.
Yeah, that is really odd. I don't know why I don't get that guy. That's weird.
Here, I'll switch the map to like a more open map where we can see him good.
Okay.
Let's go to the Chaos Waste.
Let's see this bad boy here.
Let's see, Central Chaos Waste. This will work. Everwatcher. That's cool that they added him. I might
use
him in a campaign. No. I know, man. I'm getting special treatment.
I think so. You've heard it here first, guys. You've heard it here.
I wonder if they added my own special lord for the Empire, Patchy the Saltbringer.
Well, in that case, I want a special Macedonian horse unit added to Chaos. Now that
a companion mount for Karl Franz?
Yes. Or even Ziegfeld. That'd be amazing.
Dude, he needs a mount. He needs something.
Yeah, he can walk pretty fast on foot, but man, that doesn't keep up with any other guys, the other lords that fly or ride horses.
To be fair, like, they should have some kind of, like, Chaos Cadillac for him, you know, since he's the Magnificent.
He should,
like, he
right?
He rolls up, you know, like, gets out all the cameras.
Yeah. Like, you think he would have his guard retinue with the mirrors, maybe carrying him around?
Yeah, something like that.
On rollerblades.
Like they do with Thorgrim.
Yes, exactly. Yeah, Thorgrim's more of a vanity guy. Holy cow.
They definitely need to make him have a missile attack where he throws the Book of Grudges at people.
or if he's about to take like a shot, he can pull one of his handlers like in front of him, mm-hmm. like a hostage.
Meat shields.
Yeah. All
right. So Everwatcher also has wings but can't fly. So I guess he's also in that dodo bird category.
I guess so. All right, I'm gonna camp out in the back so I can get more magic going. All right, I'm ready when you are. So, game plan's gonna be the same. I'm gonna spawn my Saigor once I can. It's called Savage Dominion.
And War of Metal is really, like, only good against Chaos.
Is it?
it's really not even that good.
I think I'll explore it some more.
They have like one spell that takes away like 15 armor, and I'll bet you that someone else has a spell that probably does that too.
Yeah, probably, or like even more.
You know, you would think that Lord Metal would have like even better, you know, against armor, right? If you can change metal.
Yeah, and for guys who dedicate their lives to studying metal,
it should like melt all the armor off, and then like everybody's standing around in their whiteies or something.
It's like an embarrassment penalty.
Yes.
Alright, let me see. Let's look at Error's guy. I've never seen this guy in my life. What the hell?
See, you're getting jacked, man.
I'm getting jacked. That guy's like a freaking raptor.
That's pretty good.
What is that? What the hell is that? Or what's that, Birdman? Birdman kicked my ass.
He's even got like a trail of chaos stink coming up behind him.
That's badass. Well, let's see if my boulder can hit him. Stop. I'm trying to run my Saigor over. Let's see if it does anything. Yeah, look at that. It's a trail of stink.
Like tendrils or something?
Something.
I don't know what that is.
Here comes the first boulder. Let's see if he can evade
Whoa.
It. Here it comes. Oh, he dodges it. This bird-like reflexes.
Yep. Dude, where's the guy from Jurassic World? He could just talk him down.
Oh, Owen?
Yeah.
That'd be
like
awesome.
Raptor Whisperer.
Oh, man! The Jedi reflexes are good with this thing, the Everwatcher.
Dude, speaking of Jedi, someone needs to mod some Jedi into the game.
That'd be or some even lightsabers?
Yeah, just something.
I would love to arm my Saigor.
How about a Grail Knight unit with lightsabers?
Yes! Or give him one of Darth Maul's blades that's double-edged.
Sometimes I wish I knew how to mod a game.
Me too. I'm at the mercy of modders.
I got no skills or time.
Oh, did that one hit?
Yeah, I'm too close to dodge it now, I think.
So I'm gonna basically run away, but that looks like a giant bird compared to my bird. Oh crap, something's happening. Something's happening.
They kind of changed the magic aura.
Oh, I totally missed. Wait, did I get you? With my spell?
I think my own... Okay, your spell's hurting me. I was like, what? Is my own spell hurting me?
What was that? All right, I'm going to try to...
All right, Everwatcher. We better get in here. We can't cheese our way back like von Karstein.
You would think so with those giant wings of his. That's like the most useless evolutionary thing on him. Oh, just like fire your guy's leaving. Let's see if I can buff my guy. Buff my Saigor.
Wow, that spell took so much magic.
Oh crap, my cursor's bugging out.
Final Transmutation takes 16 mana. It's not even that good.
What does it do?
It's supposed to be like a direct damage spell, but it barely even touched both of you.
Oh, do you target my commander with it?
I targeted like just on the ground.
Yeah.
It's pretty weak.
It didn't do anything?
I don't know, maybe it has to be like direct targeted or something.
Is your guy healing himself, or is...
No. Oh, I forgot to use all these abilities that make all my stuff, like, ward save.
Dude, there's all kinds of sweet stuff happening on your guy. I'm not sure what it is, but it looks pretty colorful. I'm gonna cast my Traitorkin. This is my direct damage spell with Malagor.
I used my ability to drop the cooldown rate before I used the stuff that actually has a cooldown. That was genius.
Let's try this thing. I'm gonna try it. I'm gonna try this breathing spell. Malagor's gonna breathe some stink at you. Oh, I totally effed it up.
Alright, Everwatcher.
Dude, your guy's taking down my Everwatcher. So I got Malagor trying to do melee to Air's giant bird here. Trying to save my Saigor.
Like if we can get the Saigor out of here, might be able to pull it off.
Yeah. I'm trying to help out. My guy's doing nothing. His melee attack is pretty bad. What's it? You have little tentacles on your feet. Let's try this devolve. See what happens. Oh crap. I devolved my own guy.
The devolve's probably gonna get me.
Let's see. It's gonna be down to the wire, guys. Oh! He's knocked my guy down.
Come on, pull out the bird powers.
Come on, get him!
dwarf pigeons.
It's like pigeon versus vulture.
The guy doesn't have any armor, but I'm gonna plague of rust anyway.
Swing! Swing at him! Swing at him! Let's...
Ah, the knockback is real.
Yeah, that's a huge knockback. So Air is working those wingspan here.
Malagor doesn't seem like he's got a whole lot when it comes to melee.
Yeah, he's not really a melee warrior.
Or maybe it's just because we were making him face against zombie dragons and giant birds.
Yeah. Against the cheese stein himself. Alright, I'm gonna cast this spell with hopefully that takes him out. That is the Traitor King again.
You know who Everwatcher reminds me of? Whoa, did they kill each other?
I think...
Or is your guy still standing?
Yeah, my guy's still... Well,
I just see wings everywhere. I can't tell what's going on.
It's like a giant feather. Who does it remind you of?
I think the Everwatcher reminds me of like when you go to the beach and you have a sandwich in your hand and the seagulls are trying to get it. I mean, I think that's like he's like the leader of all those.
Yeah, when he sees it, he just runs at it.
Taking Cheetos right out of your hand and stuff like that.
Exactly. All right. You want to switch the matchup?
Or do you want to try some other lords?
Okay.
Want to do anybody different?
All right.
Who else is around there? Bretonnia's still lonely in their corner with nothing.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure King Loon wouldn't... I don't know how he would do. Did dwarves get anything?
That's a good question. Doesn't look like it. Like, nothing new, at least. Let's see what the items are, though, like, you can put on. Let's see if they add any cool items.
Oh, yeah.
Like...
Let's go look at that.
Ungrim gets the Great Book of Grudges, which gives everybody plus 8 melee attack in a 45-meter range.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
It's not bad. Pretty handy for the dwarves.
Yeah.
Let's see about Ungrim. He, well, it just targets on himself, only lasts for 28 seconds, but he has something that can give him the Axe of Dargo. He gets extra weapon damage.
Oh,
and armor.
Dang. 36%? That's intense.
That'll kind of, I guess he's wanting some 1v1s.
So this guy has a Fiery Ring of Thori. This is basic lord.
That could be handy, honestly.
Let's see. You think so?
Well, it's a breath spell, and it causes magic and fire damage. Like, that would be pretty good against vampires.
Uh-huh.
Especially
that is true.
If they're rocking, like, the ethereal units, the magic damage is, like, it's crazy on the wraiths and the other units.
I'll try that.
Looks like the price of the runesmith actually went down.
I can't remember what the prices were.
Never mind, there's extra stuff you can add. There's more runes you can add to the runesmith. That's kind of cool.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Oath and steel. This is pretty cool. This is a lot. A lot to take in.
Damage, yeah.
The master rune of Groth One-eye.
Grunmi? Missile resistance? That's cool. Groth One-eye, sure enough.
Yeah, no,
leadership.
It's like, what is that?
So that one's constant. That's kind of interesting. It's like always on.
Oh, that's cool.
So, like, gives extra leadership. That'll make the dwarves, like, darn near unbreakable.
Yeah. You don't have to worry about casting spells for that.
There's another one that's constant. Wow.
Which one?
So, if you paid for all of them with the runesmith, which it's expensive. Like, he costs $1,437.
Yeah.
But you would have a constant 20% missile resistance and a constant plus 12 leadership and plus 8 melee attack in
Damn.
A 45 to 60 meter radius.
Damn.
So, like, all the guys around him are going to be, like... Pretty, wow.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool, actually.
He just needs to look out for von Carstein, who's just gonna...
Yeah, von Carstein would still be a problem,
yeah,
I think.
Yeah, wipe him off. So I don't care about your runes.
I wonder what else they added for, like, the Master Engineer. Now I'm curious with the dwarves. You got me curious now.
Let's go check him out.
See if they don't suck. So the Master Engineer gives a buff to weapon damage to everybody within 45 meters.
Huh.
Eh.
Yeah, I was like, meh.
What about the Thane? Whoa, the Thane's got a ton of crap he can get.
I've never used a Thane in this game, I don't
potion
think.
Potion of Toughness, Potion of Strength.
Potions.
Potion of Speed.
Oh, that's kind of cool, the Toughness.
Healing. And you can get all of them if you want to. So like a pimped out Thane. Oh, no, you can't get all of them. You can only get 4 out of the 5, it looks like.
I would definitely get the Toughness. But that makes them like the vampires.
The healing thing is cool.
Which one?
There's a potion of healing, so your Thane could, like, heal himself once.
Yeah, there's that, and also the toughness potion. It replenishes hit points of combatants.
There's, and the potion of foolhardiness makes him unbreakable and immune to psychology.
Has it ever played a role in your battles, the psychology?
Well, it means that he doesn't take the penalty of, like, terror or fear, I think.
Uh-huh.
So I want to say, I think fear obviously just gives a penalty, but I think terror has, like, a chance of routing a nearby unit momentarily or something. Like, I can't remember exactly what the...
I gotcha.
That's interesting. Well, I mean, at least the dwarves have a few more tricks up their sleeve. They need it.
That's true. Yeah, as long as they can hold their ground, they would be a lot stronger. Long enough for their cannons to do some kind of damage.
Jeez, the flame cannon's still only 180 range and cost a fortune.
I like the... Hold on.
Organ gun's pretty good, now that they buffed it in the first patch.
Yeah, organ gun's good.
What about slayers? I wonder if they changed slayers. So slayers went down in price. They're only 1,000 instead of 1,100,
ooh,
I think.
That's pretty big.
That could be big, because they got a bonus versus large.
Yeah, that's what I bring against, like, vampires, when they bring their giant monsters. And I exalt the chaos.
Adjusted any other prices. Ironbreakers are still crazy expensive. Hammers are still crazy expensive. I don't know if they buffed their stats, obviously, because I didn't look at the stats before I came in here.
Yeah, it's hard to remember. I don't remember any of these numbers.
Were Iron Drakes with Trollhammer torpedoes... I don't remember how much they cost, but they might be a little cheaper, too.
Let's see.
I think they are. They're 1,100. I think they used to be, like, 13 or something.
I think you're right. Yeah, I guess they dropped them. Because, you know, they were pretty good, but they could have been better, so I think lower cost is...
Anyway, I guess I'm done looking at the dwarves. I was having too much fun there.
No, that's cool. A lot more information for the people watching. Oh, you know what? Would you mind if you did a quick Malagor versus Khazrak? Just for the hell of it.
Beastman feud?
Yeah. I'll try Khazrak.
Do you want him in a chariot? Or you want Khazrak?
Oh, okay. You can take him if you want.
I got Malagor.
Alright.
We're good.
So, I don't have any spells. It's just, he's a melee guy. I got Scourge.
Okay. I brought everything I can bring.
Alright. Let's see. Am I completely pimped out?
Oh, wait. We need to go back to Beastman land.
Oh, yes.
Let's try a different one. I'm trying to think which one we were in. I think we were in...
Oh, I forgot the name already.
We were in the Heart of the Dark.
Ooh, someone's messaging.
Volcanic Channels. This isn't Beastmen focused, but it's kind of cool.
Let's try it. That looks like Lord of the Rings almost.
What?
The volcano one looks like Lord of the Rings.
Why did it switch me back to Chaos?
It's a sign. I think it's CA telling you they want you to use it, so you can promote their new unit,
okay,
which I don't have.
Yeah, there we go. Yeah, apparently, like, it switched me back to Chaos and picked the Everwatcher again.
It's a sign, man. I told you guys, CA favors him.
Dude, you got hacked by CA.
I think so. I think Joey's up to no good right now.
They're hacking content out of your game.
Next, I'll hack my YouTube.
Dude, my Lionheart and I got hacked on Twitter. It was great.
I heard about that. How'd you get it fixed?
Oh, Twitter eventually fixed it for both of us.
Did you find out who did it?
Yeah, I mean, the guys who did it, like, tagged themselves in it. And the funny thing is, I don't even think Twitter ever closed their account. Like,
oh, jeez.
So
that's ridiculous.
I guess they're kind of loose on all that, but...
I'd be a little pissed.
Oh, wait. I brought Khazrak. Whoops.
Yeah. I brought Malagor.
Did you bring Malagor?
That is weird. I thought I brought Khazrak, but apparently I had Malagor.
All right, well, whatever. Yeah. It works out.
Let's do it. All right.
Dude, I've got a pimped out chariot here.
Yeah, I think the chariot could do some damage, but if I can keep behind Sigor, it might help me out. I'm going
to
hide.
Looks like he's riding to the Beastman prom, pick up his date.
What kind of date would a Beastman take? A Beastwoman?
He's trying to steal Sigvald's girlfriend.
Ooh, I think Sigvald is his own girlfriend.
That's quite possible.
I think so. He's like, no one's worthy of me. So as I try to charge up, I'm gonna basically hide in the very back. Because I don't want to take.
How do you like this volcanic tunnel?
It's pretty cool. Let's look over. I wonder if you can go down there. No, you can't.
I'm not gonna lie. It would be cool if you could order your men off of the like broken bridge.
That'd be awesome. You could do like a Gandalf last stand.
Yep. Shall not pass.
Thou shall not. Corner camp.
Shall not corner camp.
That's right.
They need to make a spell called that.
That'd be awesome.
It's like corner shaped, and if you drop it in the corner, like, it wrecks everything there.
Oh, check it out, guys. This is the Khazrak unit. That's Air. He's like an Arkansas like Razorback.
Yeah, I know. Pig Suey.
Alright, he's getting too close to me. I'm going to obviously take out my Saigor.
I'm pretty sure Khazrak is going to lose his one eye. I don't think this is going to end well for him.
He's going to have a black eye in the only eye that he has.
I think the Chariot will work okay versus like your wizard, Malagor, but he's going to get absolutely smashed, I think, by the Saigor.
I'm going to do something really lame. I'm going to corner camp over here. See if that helps me. Maybe it'll stop you from charging me. Yeah, let's try that. We're going to take these units to their maximum abuse. Alright, let's see if I'm
pretty sure Khazrak can grab some strips of bacon off the back of his ride if he needs to replenish health.
Oh, that'd be awesome. He'd be self-sufficient, man. Alright, so I'm getting my boulder ready, and Air's taking some evasive action here.
Oh.
Did that do splash damage? No.
No, it hit the ground.
Come on, Saigor.
I think there is splash damage on the boulder, though.
Ooh, well, that's like a fake throw.
Is it psych out?
I think so.
Alright, get him.
Interception mode. Intercept it.
Ah, oh, the extra speed didn't get me there.
Hit him.
Get him.
Hit him. Bash his one eye in. Oh,
the chariot's like only good for charges, basically. Like, it can kind of hurt infantry blobs, but I've noticed chariots in this game are like so different than scythe chariots were in Rome 2.
Oh, yeah, they're way different.
Like, you have to like charge and then like turn around backwards. Like, it's the weirdest thing.
I was trying to cast my spell, but you moved.
It's like massive babysitting.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, this chariot is completely worthless.
It's pretty clumsy.
It's gonna only be good if you're like trying to smash like big blobs of goblins or something in campaign.
So I'm trying to hide behind Saigor here.
No, it's gonna make it really hard.
It's just like keep away.
Dude, people do it to me with von Carstein all the time. It's like you're going after him and he's like slithering behind a bunch of zombies and you can't ever get to him.
Yeah, he's like, you'll never catch me.
I think one of my commentaries, I said he was slipperier than a greased weasel, and I still stand by that. It's pretty...
Now that is a hot visual. I can just picture that in my head.
Yeah, Carstein's getting all greased up before battle.
He's wearing some weasel fur.
It's like, hey, you, undead, grease me up.
Exactly. Grease it now, guys. Grease my bald head.
They have to empty the camp deep fryer and, you know, like...
Oh, crap! He got his charge off! Save me, Saigor!
Yeah, this is like the most worthless lord ever. Like, if you're going against monsters, not recommending Khazrak.
Yeah, I think he might be good against maybe the Empire.
I think the one eye is definitely hurting his depth perception, too.
I think so. He's not qualified to be a driver. Alright, so maybe we should drop Khazrak for now.
Yeah, he's lame.
He's lame.
He's just going to be Spirit Leech bait. So let's see.
Who else can we try out?
He doesn't really have very good abilities. Like, I'm sitting here looking at him. He's got the one item. And it, like, kind of hurts.
The one item?
Well, you have to attack someone for it to do it to him.
Yeah.
Which is kind of cool. Like, it drops a bunch of their stats. But I don't know. Like, we'll have to see. If there's monsters around, I think he's getting hammered.
Oh, jeez. Ironically, he has a thing called here, the Apocalyptic Vision. Considering he only has one eye. It's like, it's ironic.
Dude, should we do a apocalyptic non-vision?
Yeah.
Should we try out the Minotaurs?
Let's do it.
Stuff?
Let's do it.
Here, I'll bring a Cryptor or something. Let's go Minotaurs versus Cryptor.
Okay, and then let's keep our commanders out of it?
Yeah. Okay. Just keep them in the back. Yeah, just make sure that, like, take away all their abilities so there's, like, nothing map-wide or anything that's...
Okay. Wait, which Minotaur do you want? There's one with shields, great weapons, or just a regular Minotaur?
Let me see if Cryptors really don't have any armor, so I would just bring bring the regular one.
Okay.
And a shielded one, and then I'll bring 2 units of Cryptors and we can test them.
Okay. So, yeah, my Minotaur costs 1,400, and then my Minotaur shields cost 1,500.
Yeah, my guys are only 800, so I would expect a pretty crushing defeat here.
We shall see.
But, I mean, vampires. We'll see.
Vampires, that's right. And yeah, we're not going to use our generals at all. They're going to be in the back, chilling. Lore,
all right, here we go.
Of vampires.
Lore of light?
What is that?
Who has lore of light?
It sounds like an empire ability.
Maybe they changed, because the pre-battle screen was like giving away units, right? Like it was telling you units that your enemy was using. Maybe they changed it because it said lore of light. Like no one here has lore of light.
Oh, let's see. Hold on. I brought a beast lord. Let's see. Nope, he does not have that.
Just to make all things equal, you want to just like spread your guys as thin as they can go?
Yeah. We'll just charge at each other?
Yeah, and I think there's some pretty equal looking ground in the center. It's not perfect, but it's close.
All right.
I doubt it's good.
Oh, let me show my close-ups of my Minotaurs really fast. These are the Minotaurs.
They're pretty good looking.
Yeah, they're pretty sweet. They're charging up like a bull.
And they come straight from the labyrinth.
Yes. They're looking out for whoever slayed them. All right, ready?
All right.
Wait, you want to come out charging or charge later on?
We'll meet in the middle and then we can charge each other.
Okay.
And we'll try and separate the two units far enough apart where they don't like touch each other.
Okay. I'm gonna put one on the left, one on the right. All right.
Fast forward for a second.
Okay. How do I do that?
All right. Hopefully, I mean, I would think the Minotaurs are gonna absolutely smoke the Cryptors for the price difference. You would hope.
I hope so. How much do your guys cost?
800.
Oh yeah, this should be a slaughter.
Dude, I mean, Cryptors are a bargain. Like every form of the word bargain.
Yeah. All right, ready?
Yeah, right. I mean, it's a bit of a downhill for my guys, but it's not that bad. I mean, we'll see what happens.
All right, here it goes, guys. So these are Air's Cryptors. Hey, what is that?
I don't know.
I didn't do that.
Yeah, it's just something.
Yes.
I have no idea.
So these are my shield.
Did my guys knock back your Minotaurs?
I didn't notice it. Something definitely happened, though.
Looks like my guys are losing.
Yeah, they are on this side, where my regular Minotaurs are. Straight to your left, my shielded ones are pretty equal with yours.
Okay, that's right. One of yours is shielded, one isn't.
Yeah. I would have thought my ones without the shields would have been doing worse, maybe. This is pretty cool, though. They're about the same size.
Yeah, it looks like the shielded ones. No, that's just the standard Minotaur. It's already winning its fight.
Maybe the shield's is an encumbrance.
It might lower their attack. I didn't look at the stats before we came in.
That might be it.
Dude. No, I mean, that's to be expected, though. I mean, the Cryptors were a lot cheaper. They're getting the crap pounded out of them.
Yeah.
But if they won, I would definitely have to be a little bit upset at that.
Yeah.
Yeah, clean win on that side with the normal ones.
Yeah, I'm going to move that unit away.
I wonder why it's closer. The shielded ones maybe have, like, less attack or something?
Yeah, it might be because they're not using both arms, maybe.
Let's see, melee attack 32 on the other one. Yeah, melee attack's 40 on the other one.
Gotcha, so I guess Minotaurs...
And you get more defense. So...
Yeah, so we're expecting these guys and without the shields. But I guess there's other units you have to worry about, too.
Yeah, I mean, that was like a easy victory for
the Minotaurs.
Regular Minotaurs.
Yeah. Oh, can we try Malagor Sigor against the Chaos Giant?
Chaos Giant versus the Sigor?
Yeah.
Sure.
Let's try that.
Here. Let's see.
Who do you want to be?
Who do you want me to bring? I'm good with whatever.
Okay, you can bring Malagor if you want.
Alright.
And I'll get my Chaos...
So you want me to just, like, spawn a Sigor to go against the Chaos Giant?
Yeah, I just want to see who wins. I'm sure the stats say it all, but I want to see for myself. So I'm going to bring a regular Chaos Lord just to sit out of the fight, and then...
Yeah, I'll keep Malagor back.
So Chaos Giant costs 1,600.
Yeah, I'm going to switch the map back to somewhere we got better visibility.
Alright, cool.
Land battle... can't ever remember the maps that are like actually somewhat flat.
I can never remember that either, because it's hard to tell just based on the preview.
What does MP stand for?
Might be multiplayer, map? Maybe.
I wonder so, because they have MP Peak Pass. They look like more balanced maps. Like,
I guess that makes sense then if it's multiplayer.
Like Shogun 2 type map.
You want to try one?
Yeah, that's actually kind of cool. Dude, Alpine Ridge. It's like a throwback to Shogun 2. It's got like a little ridge in the center.
Oh, that's almost like, what do you get? Is it Empire? Or Napoleon even?
Yeah, they had one on that too.
Yeah.
Yeah, it looks like they put like a set of balanced maps in here or something.
That's awesome.
It has MP in front of it.
That's definitely handy.
Here's one that's just like a flat map. We could just go on it. The Reach River?
That sounds cool.
Let's take Crossroads, see if it's... There we go. All right.
All right. All right, let's switch back to the Chaos.
Dude, I might have to make a video rubbing it in that I got, like, the Raptor from Chaos.
Yeah, you should. And then I'll show you my screen, where it's just, like, nothing there.
Got jacked.
It's a conspiracy, guys. What's up with that? They've probably seen all my pro-Ziegfeld videos. They couldn't handle it. We can't show the general populace.
Have you been rolling Ziegfeld into battle? Because if so, I need to go watch it.
Oh, yeah. You haven't seen him?
No, I need to go watch it.
Do it. I've been putting a lot of sexy intros with him. We're like, this one a few days ago. Check it out. And, don't unfriend me after you watch it.
Dude, if it's half as good as, like, the old videos you made where, what was it, like, the songs or whatever you're doing in like the Rome Total War or whatever.
Oh yeah, the videos.
Those were brilliant.
I'll have to do that again. I need to sing a song about Ziegfeld.
About Ziegfeld. Oh man, that was classic. The Greek cavalry song. Like, I don't know if that can ever be replaced.
Oh man, I miss that one.
What? Wasn't that like the Beverly Hillbillies tune or whatever?
Yeah. What to do a duet sometime?
Oh man, I don't know if you want me singing.
Oh dude,
That was pretty funny. But, I enjoyed those.
Well, thank you.
Some original content there.
Yeah, I made sure I took them off my channel. I didn't want to get in trouble with copyright.
Oh, did you have to?
I wasn't sure if it was going to hit me or not, because the background music wasn't mine.
Oh, okay, yeah, they probably would then.
Yeah, so just to be sure I made that, quote-unquote, karaoke channel.
Karaoke channel.
Yeah. Like, it's been pretty inactive, but I'd like to hit it up again. It's just... It's embarrassing. Alright, here comes Air's guy. I'm gonna try to charge him so I don't have to take too many boulders in my face. Actually, I'm gonna try to dodge his boulders first. Might be kind of hard with a giant, though.
Catch.
Alright, here he goes. Here, look at this fast-forward evasive action here.
Yeah. Definitely a high-speed battle between these two.
Yeah. I see a high-speed chase between these two guys. Alright, he's winding up. You can tell he's winding up. He projects his motions.
Dude, this looks like the new version of the grassy flatlands or something.
Oh yeah, you're right. I wonder if you could hide in this tall grass back here.
Dude, that was... You're talking some old-school knowledge now. Like, I don't even know if a lot of the viewers are familiar with the gray area on the grassy flatlands.
They're probably unsubscribing right now. Like, what the hell is that?
I remember a few times, like, going into battle, and I'd just be, like, fighting it, and I'd totally forget about the gray area, and I'd be like, where'd all that crap come from?
Yeah, no. I've done so many times where I'd hide, like half my army in, like, one patch of grass, and the guy would be like, hey, that didn't make any sense. That's unrealistic. Here comes, guys.
It's like Mufasa talking to Simba. Like, all this in one day of years, except that gray area over there. Don't be in there.
Hey, the rock didn't do too much damage to my guy.
Alright, Saigor.
Here you go, guys.
Come on. Give him the curveball.
This is what you've been training for your whole life.
See him, like, stamping his feet, you know, getting ready like he's a real pitcher.
Exactly.
It's like, alright, here we go.
Foul!
Oh!
Right in his legs!
That's a groin shot, man.
Damn.
He actually, Saigor pitches below the belt.
I think so. Here he goes. Oh, he just goes down.
Dude, kick him while he's down.
Kick him! Look, your guy's facing the wrong way. What's gonna happen?
Dude, if the Saigor keeps getting knocked around like that, he's gonna get wrecked.
Yeah, I know. He needs to turn around and use that boulder. Oh! Oh!
Is he going for the headbutt?
I think so. think my guy needs to take a folding chair out and just hit him in the back.
Folding chair? Yeah. That'd be classic.
Yeah, take this!
Hey, there's another mod request for anybody's mod. Mod some folding chairs in for the giant.
Exactly. Make it a giant folding chair. He just takes it out of the ground. Like, out of nowhere. Alright, so it looks like the Sigor did some damage.
Yeah, he's getting pasted.
Yeah. But considering it's just, you know, it's almost a free unit.
Yeah, can't go wrong there.
Yeah.
Here comes the very slow chase.
Yeah, here comes guy. Like,
get back here, dude.
Oh, I'm gonna get you. Is your guy shattered? Alright. You wanna try a different matchup?
Yeah, all right. Let's try something different. Here we go.
Alright, what do you think?
Trying to think what else we should try from the Beastmen. What else cool did they come up with here?
Let's see. Beastmen.
What about their cavalry? Centaurs with great weapons.
Hmm.
And their vanguard deployed too.
Yeah.
Dude, their stats look pretty trash-tacular though.
Do they?
They do. They look pretty bad.
I think that was one criticism of these guys. Like on the board game, I think they had like low armor or something like that.
Oh yeah. None of these guys really have much armor. But they're fast, and it looks like they have a lot of Vanguard deploy units. Yeah, they do. They have a crap load of Vanguard deploy units.
Do you want to test them out against, like, say, Griffin or the Demigryphs?
Demigryph's going to flat these guys. Like, it's not even going to be a battle.
Or do you think maybe,
So they have standard Centaurs, which are shielded, very fast, Vanguard deployment.
They sound like scouts to me.
Yeah, and then you've got the Centaurs with great weapons. But I mean, their weapon strength's only 34. Melee attack 20. Like, I mean, they're pretty weak.
Yeah.
Charge bonus is only 35. Like,
we should try their top-of-the-line one, then. Their Centaur. Great weapons.
That is the top-of-the-line.
Yeah.
That's as good as it gets.
All right. What would be a good match for it?
Apparently these guys don't invest much in cavalry. I'm wondering, so, like, is there any cavalry that's around, like, 900? What about, like, Empire Knights?
Let's see. Empire Knights are 900. Like,
bring a Reichsguard and an Empire Knight.
Okay. And I'll bring a crappy...
I'm going to upgrade one of these Centaurs to the cost of the Reichsguard.
Yeah, okay, it's 1,200.
Yeah. My guys are 950, though, so I don't know if you can put a Chevron on your Empire Knights and make it the same cost.
Okay, it comes up to 955.
Yeah, it's close. It's within 5.
Yeah.
All right.
All right, ready?
Yep.
All right, so
these guys are gonna get schooled by the Empire Cavalry.
We'll see. I'm gonna put
Knights of the Realm are about the same cost too. We could try that too.
Yeah, that's true. Hey, I'm gonna put my Reichsguard on your left.
Okay. Man, do you remember some of the other fun stuff from like Rome Total War? Like whenever someone have a unit upgraded, you could see the little flags on them.
Oh yeah.
Like all the little tricks, you know, that you had to learn.
Exactly.
You know, should we spread them as thin as you can?
Yeah.
Just to make it equal.
Alright, so there's like 3 ranks.
Yeah.
Yeah. Let's leave my commander way out in the back. Alright. We could come out charging in this one.
Yeah.
Alright, I'm ready when you are.
Let's do it. Alright, here we go.
Here we go, guys. Let's go look at these.
This map will be nice for, if you're wanting, like, completely balanced.
Yeah.
It's
damn.
It's come a long way since the grassy flatlands, too. Like, you still get the mountains in the background.
Yeah, I kind of like that. It's flat and even. Man, you guys are really fast.
Yeah, they are quick. It's 91 speed.
Let's go see what happens here.
Oh, dude, my guy's being rushed.
There you go. Oh, yeah, your health went down, like, on impact. Holy cow.
Let's see how the drawn out. Well, they're doing a lot more damage now. But my guys just got beat so bad on the charge.
Yeah, charge destroyed them.
They're doing a considerable amount of health damage while they're in, like, extended melee, though.
Yeah. Oh, the Empire Knights are getting hammered right now.
Yeah, they are. Dude, that's crazy. How does that work?
I don't know.
Armor piercing, maybe?
That's weird. It says I have 2 chevrons. I only put 1 chevron on there.
Yeah, it must be because they killed my guys so hard.
Oh, yeah, maybe that's why. That was weird. How many guys do you have? You have 29?
So, what? That's my guys beat your Empire Knight?
That was weird.
Oh, no, dude. We had it. What? We have it backward. No, okay. Both of my guys were Centaurs with great weapons. trying to make sure I had it right here.
Whoa, you guys gained so much experience. Look at that. They have silver experience from killing my guys.
Okay, yeah, both were Centaurs with great weapons. Dude, that's weird that they beat the Empire Knights after losing so bad on the charge. It's gotta be the armor piercing, and like the Empire Knights don't get the armor piercing damage.
Yeah, that's true.
What was the starting health? I didn't catch that. We'll have to go back and look on the other screen.
Okay. Yeah. Alright.
Let's see what the health was there. That was weird.
That
I did
was
not expect
weird.
Them to win that. Well, there you go. That's why you tested.
Yeah, exactly.
So the Centaurs with great weapons have 4,050 health.
Oh, do they really?
Yeah, what's the health on an Empire Knight?
Empire Knight is 4,140.
So they have better health.
And then on my... Yeah.
Well, like, basically all the damage off the Centaur is armor-piercing, though. It's like 27 armor-piercing damage.
Uh-huh.
So I'm guessing that's what does it.
That might have been it. But that's kind of demoralizing for the Beastmen, that their top-of-the-line unit can almost hold up to the lowest Empire Cav unit.
Yeah, so Cav's definitely not going to be these guys.
Yeah,
so.
It's definitely not going to be it.
Should we try a Razorgor Chariot?
Yeah, let's try that. You want to try it against...
Do you want to do the Chariot, or do you want me to do the Chariot?
You can do the Chariot. Who do you want to match it against? Another Chariot?
Bring, like...
I know Chaos has a Chariot.
Let's bring a couple of different units. I'll bring a couple of Chariots. Like, you want to just bring, like, an infantry? Like, a couple infantry units?
Oh, sure. Like this Hold My Ground?
Yeah, let's just see if it can, like, cut through any infantry.
Would be good, like, Bretonnia, maybe?
Yeah. Bring some of, like, the, bring, like, a couple units of spears and a couple of units of pole arms. And...
All right. Tell me how much you spend, and I'll spend the same amount.
Well, I mean, the Razorgor Chariots are 1,100.
Okay, so that's what... That's gonna be, like, one pole arm and maybe two...
I think you can get two pole arms and then, like, probably three or almost four spearmen.
Wait, for 1,100?
Close, isn't it? Unless they change the price on...
Yeah, right now, I'm at... Let's see, 600... 1,150 right now, with just two spearmen and one pole arm.
I don't know, but I've got two Razorgor Chariots.
Oh, you got two? Okay, I gotcha.
Yeah, so you can double it up.
All right. Let me make sure I do that right. Let's see, four times two is 1,200...
As long as it's close, it'll be good enough.
Okay. Cool. No upgrades, yeah?
I'm not running any upgrades on mine.
All right. So I'm just going to hold my ground, I guess.
Dude, how come CA didn't make it to where I could put spinner rims on these chariots?
No, remember those things on bikes that
they
make that noise when you turn
clackers.
Your wheel? Yeah.
they should have that on here, like a little bell, like... That causes terror.
Ding, ding. Or like a kid chariot unit and his like training wheels on his.
Yeah.
All right, I'll leave my.
Do you want to just make two groups of guys? Like put like one group on the right, one on the left, and I'll attack them kind of separately with the Razor Gore.
You mean like form a mini squares out of them, or?
Yeah, just whatever you think.
Okay. Let's try that.
Yeah. Basically, it's like three of the chariots that Khazrak was riding in. In each group.
All right, you can try a funnel charge if you want.
Yeah, I'm gonna
right into
see
the.
See what I can do.
Let's see here.
But with all the Vanguard deployment and the quick speed, I can see the Beastmen, you know, like giving people trouble in the sense that it's like Bretonnia when someone spawns like three or four Pegasus Knights behind you or something.
That's true. Yeah, like one of the things about the Beastmen apparently on tabletop was that they're rewarding if you can manage to win, but it's so hard to win as the Beastmen. Alright, here we go. So check that out, man. How do you like them apples?
That's gonna be nasty. We'll give it a shot.
Alright,
I'm guessing swordsmen would get pretty properly wrecked by chariots, but spearmen should be able to brace.
Yeah. Well, you want me to check up at my spearmen in the front? My pole arms?
You can do whatever you want. It's all good.
I'll put it in the front, on the one on your left. See if that helps.
Dude, I was so glad that they kind of changed a few things in this game to where you don't have to like spread your men out into like two lines.
That's true. Like the spaghetti lines.
Yeah, that was getting so annoying.
Yeah, it also looks pretty damn ugly.
Yes. It's like a grand phalanx, two men deep.
We can hold 100 people.
All Alright, here we go. Let's see what the initial charge looks like.
Should I toggle the guard mode? Oh, no, it's good. Never mind. Alright. So, one on the right, that's where my pole arms are up front. That's what happens.
That was pretty weak.
Yeah, it's kind of anticlimactic. Alright, I'm going to target
Razorgor, more like Sponge Gore.
I think so. Sponge Gore Square Chariots.
Here, bring out one unit and turn it around backwards. Let's see if these guys can do anything in like a best case scenario.
Okay. I will pull my pole arms out.
Maybe that just speaks to, you know, like how good like braced spear units would be against this, though.
Yeah.
They stop them dead in their tracks, pretty much.
I'm going to pull my guys back a little bit away from that. Oh, no, don't charge just yet.
Yeah, do you like the William Wallace, like, guys bent over and moaning the enemy thing?
Exactly. Here? This is what we think of your giant Razorbacks.
All right, here we go.
All right.
Let's see what happens. Best case scenario.
Here goes, guys.
Okay, it was pretty good.
That's pretty good. Oh, man. Let's see if any get back up.
Wow.
They all got back up.
So it didn't necessarily kill them all, but, I mean...
Yeah, this is
the bracing bonus is real.
Yeah, that's some serious damage.
So an unbraced unit is going to get pretty wrecked.
Mm-hmm.
Should I see what happens if I charge a flank?
Yeah, try that.
Let's do a flank over here and we'll see what happens. See if you get a bracing bonus on the flank. Nope.
Bullying. Well, they did all stop, right. Like, towards the middle. Oh, whoa. Yeah.
I'm going to leave him in combat and see what happens.
Yeah, see what happens. I'm going to target your guy.
Here. So this one, like, pull out one unit of spears, and I'll go, like, head-on and leave him in combat, and we'll see what happens.
Wait, do what now? Sorry.
Put, like, one unit out in front of this other one, and I'll go head-on into it while it's braced, and we'll see if it can do any damage.
Okay.
They're actually doing okay in, like, prolonged melee. They're definitely taking damage, though, to your halberds.
Yeah, pretty good. Wait, you pull this one out? The one's already engaged? Or just the other one?
Is this one here? I'll charge this halberd right here.
Okay.
See how it does.
Sorry.
Because they're braced and facing me, so we're good.
So it happens. Oh, wow. You guys got through that.
It must have been
one.
The extra bracing from your other two units behind it.
That might have been it. Wow. You want to try them? Here, try charging one of my spearmen then.
See if it's the same.
Yeah, because maybe the spearmen have...
Yeah, dude, the halberds beasted that out whenever they got stopped.
All right, let me pull this guy out of here. Here, I'll pull a spearman towards your one that's not engaged. I'll pull my other guys back.
Yeah, the pole arms clean them up, no problem, whenever they stop charging.
Yeah, I think it's definitely the spearmen that held their ground.
All right, maybe so, we'll see. Do the pole arms, they have charge defense? Yeah, they both have charge defense.
I feel like the shield has more of a bearing on it, maybe. We'll see. All right.
Pole arms don't have shields. No. Okay.
Here you go.
We'll see.
You guys gonna brace or what? They're just sitting there. Oh, here we go.
There they go. They held better.
Yeah, I think they did. Well, yeah. It's probably the combination of all of them.
Let's see. Yeah, it doesn't take long when they get left in combat, though. Those spearmen are doing some pretty significant damage.
Yeah. That's a pretty sweet close-up.
I'm going to see how hard it is to pull out once you get engaged like this. If I turn around and pull out.
Yeah, try it.
It's not too bad as long as you go out the same direction you came in.
Yeah.
Should I try a pull through?
Yeah, try it. Let me reform my lines here.
Yeah, I'll let you brace and then I'll charge and try and pull through.
Like they got all bloodied up, but only lost, what, 12 men?
You guys definitely took the better of that engagement.
Yeah, I think so. Alright. We're gonna try the pull through here, guys. They are going through.
It's not... super easy.
Yeah. They made it. Well, this last one's got stuck. Oh!
I didn't take a ton of damage pulling through, but I took some.
Yeah.
I do kind of like how they made the chariot pull through, like, kind of toned down. It was crazy in Rome, man.
Oh,
like,
man, yeah.
Pull through everything.
This damn chariot Egypt armies were, like, the worst. Like, even the chariot archers were pretty tough.
You remember, like, in regular Rome Total War, where you had, like, the Britannia armies with, like, all the chariots? Oh, my gosh, dude. The head hurlers and the chariots. That was brutal.
Yeah. Yeah, Egypt and Britannia.
Oh, yeah. The Pharaoh's bowmen.
Yeah. Like, they all worked with CWP rules, but you can get slingers and archers.
Oh, CWP.
CWP. Oh man, you guys wrecked my guys that time.
Now, that time I got through pretty clean because you didn't have enough men, I guess, to hold.
Yeah.
Huh, interesting.
Man, the blood is real.
I mean, the chariot's pretty much only going to be good on the move, obviously. So.
Yeah.
I'm guessing they suck versus cavalry because they can't knock it over.
I feel like you're right.
Anyway, I'm good there unless you want to see something else.
But hey, do you want to try Khazrak versus Franz, maybe?
Yeah, let's on the ground.
Yeah.
Like one. Should we do like no abilities?
We could try that.
Like man versus beast.
That's a good name of the video.
Dude, you should make a video where you go Sigvald versus him, and it'll be Beauty and the Beast.
I kind of like that one, actually. Oh, man. All right, you got it up far? Okay, I'll do the Beastmen.
Okay, here we go. Carl Franz, I'm going to go no mount, no abilities.
All right, so yeah, I'm not bringing my chariot this time.
Okay, so straight Franz.
All right, I'll turn off my abilities. Should we bring the items? No. No mount?
Yeah, I don't have any items.
Okay.
I'm good.
Let's see what happens. I feel like Carl Franz's hammer is going to do some pretty good damage. We'll see.
We can take a look at the stats when we go on, but I'm guessing that Franz is going to take it.
I think so.
If Kolek wasn't around, Grimgor, I think, would 1v1 anybody.
That is true.
But, I mean,
you know,
Dragon Ogre's kind of a problem.
Yeah. I was curious about, like, Sigvald. It says he can take the charge of any unit. But I've tried it. He gets his
ass... The problem is he still gets knocked down.
Yeah, he gets his ass knocked down really bad.
So even if he doesn't take the charge damage, like, he still gets knocked around, so...
Yeah, so he's at a disadvantage when he's on the ground. This guy looks pretty cool off his chariot.
Does he?
Yeah. I'm just gonna see his eye. Hold on. I gotta zoom in.
There's no way the feathers in your hat are as cool as the one that Carl has, though.
Oh, my guy only has a horn.
And the cape. I mean, Franz has the cape.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Wait a minute. Okay, yeah. All right, ready? Let's go. That's fast.
No one can match. Even Sigvald's got to be jealous of that cape.
Sigvald's pretty magnificent with his white cape, though. Maybe we should do Sigvald versus... No.
Do you think... So is this, like... I'm guessing the Empire was, like, derived off the Holy Roman Empire?
Yeah, like the... Late medieval, close high Renaissance, or whatever you call it.
So, who would America be in, like the Warhammer realm? Are we the Beastmen?
Let me see. I guess kind of like the old Wars of Chaos, where we're all just kind of one people, maybe. I don't know. I would definitely say the dwarves could be. I don't know. Dwarves and chaos could be a mix of Scandinavia.
Got the Norsekins.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, dude, check him out with his, like, whip, dude. He's channeling the Indiana Jones there.
And your guy's freaking Thor. Thing's glowing. All right, I'm gonna start charging you now. There he goes. All right.
Go, Carl. Go, Carl.
Go, Khazrak. Go, Khazrak. Oh, that was epic.
No one got knocked back.
Yeah. Oh, I'm surprised. It's looking pretty cool.
Let's see.
Damage about even.
Franz has good melee attack.
Ooh, my health is really good on Khazrak.
So better weapon strength on Khazrak, but it looks like Carl has like armor piercing.
Oh, does he? Well, I think my guy even has armor on him.
I don't know. Your guy, hold on, let me see. Yeah, you have better weapon strength, but Carl, you'll have to look at it. My guy's got 290 armor piercing.
Mine has no armor piercing. It's got a 60 melee attack.
Yeah, it looks like Franz took it. That's pretty close, actually.
Yeah, you want to try it again? See if it's different?
Sure. It is a pretty close fight.
Yeah.
I didn't have much health. I think you had as much health as I did. I think your guy just routed.
Yeah. Wait, my guy routed?
Must have. Mine said defeat. Wow, that was close then.
Yeah. Let's try it again. We'll switch it up. You'll be Carl.
You want me to switch over to Khazrak?
Yeah. Just to see. Let's turn off all these crap things.
See if CA really did hack your game.
I think so. Joey, where's my raptor?
You got the Prince of Macedon hex. Like,
I think I did. Or maybe they give something else that'll compensate. Like, I can't think of anything right now, but something really good, like pizza.
They're going to make you buy a DLC called The Ruin of Compensation.
It's like $50. You will buy this. I will not stand idle. All right, Heldenhammer, or Galmaron. All right. Moving. So yeah, Karl Franz does have the armor piercing.
Let's see what the armor piercing is here. So 160 armor piercing on Khazrak. So lower armor piercing, just more overall weapon strength?
I guess so.
What's your melee attack? My guy's 64.
Mine is 65.
Defense is 50 for mine.
Mine's only 30. Maybe it's a 34 defense.
34 or 5 health.
And mine's 29, 24 health.
That's probably the difference right there. So your guy's going to do more armor piercing, but probably enough health on Khazrak that he can keep it close.
Yeah. But I feel like Khazrak isn't even armored, so I don't think my armor piercing does anything.
Ooh, actually, it could be a lot of charge bonus, too. 62 charge bonus.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
All right. Let's see what happens.
Yours is probably says 60. Actually, Carl's got some charge. That's more than I thought.
Here he goes again, guys. Boo, poo, poo. Whoa! You gotta put his head into my guy.
Yeah, he's, like, going straight for the headbutt.
Yeah. That would be cool if there was a knockdown with that. Let's go look at the health here. Yeah, my health is down again. I mean, Karl Franz's health is down again.
I think Carl's doing more damage. Khazrak just has enough health.
I think so. Oh, can we try Khazrak versus Sigfald after this?
Sure.
I just want to see, just because I'm a fanboy.
If Sigfald gets the charge stuff, though, like, he may be able to... I mean, but it seems like Sigvald's got pretty low health, too.
Yeah, he does. I wonder if that Auric ability would help him any. The Auric armor.
Dude, Franz is getting wrecked this time for some reason.
Yeah. It must have been the head charge.
I don't know what it was, but...
It was something. Yeah, I think Carl Franz is going to lose again.
Dude, he got whooped.
Yeah. Yeah, that was another loss for Carl.
Come on, Carl.
Oh, Carl, you let the Empire down.
Yeah, the women of the Empire are weeping. They're about to be weeping, too, when they see Sigvald.
Exactly. All right. Let me see.
All right, so we're wanting to do Sigvald versus...
Khazrak.
All right, I got Khazrak ready.
All right. Are we turning off the abilities again?
Yeah.
All right, let me turn off my crap.
Mono e Magnificent.
Yes. This is going to be the Beauty and the Beast matchup.
Yeah.
Here he goes, guys.
Beauty and the Beast.
Because mine says charge defense, should I just sit there and take your charge? What do you think?
That's a good question. I don't think it works unless you're sitting still.
All right. I'll get close enough.
But then you don't get a charge bonus either.
Yeah, that's true.
But if his charge bonus is low, I would say you're probably better to just take it.
Just take it? I'll take it and then attack afterwards. Slayer, let's try that.
What's your charge bonus?
My charge bonus is... 45.
Yeah, I would take it then. Like, I would just sit still.
Yeah.
We can always try a second one and charge.
Okay. I'll get a little close to you before I sit still.
Yeah, I'll make sure you're fully braced.
Here he is, guys.
I want to see the magnificence here.
Jeez, look at that.
Look at him, like, casually striding into battle.
I know, he's like, man, I don't care about this DLC, guys.
This cape really looks good in the wind.
I think even with the blood, he's still going to look really regal anyways.
Yeah, he's like, it's cashmere.
This is custom made in Italy, guys.
Yeah, what about the loincloth, too? I mean...
Yeah, I hope there's like a map that has a lot of wind. I want to see what it looks like. Not what it looks like, but...
Dude, from behind, he kind of looks like he's rocking like the WWF like wrestling...
Yeah, the shorts?
...undies or something.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Check out my Sigvald video, because... Yeah, I do some close-ups.
I'll definitely have to go check that out. I haven't seen it yet.
Alright, I'm gonna stop right here.
Alright.
And then, once you charge, I'm gonna start attacking him.
Let's see if this charge bonus, or charge, so basically my guy shouldn't get any bonus, but he's still going to deal damage, you know?
Yeah, let's see. Here he goes.
But it looks like Sigvald countered him while he charged.
I think so. Alright,
I think it worked.
Oh, I'm not taking damage now from your crap.
Sigvald doesn't do armor piercing, though. That's going to hurt him, I think.
Yeah. Ooh. Let's see, how does it look? Yeah, my guy's falling really fast.
I mean, he did take the charge well, it kind of seemed like, but...
Yeah, and that was about it. That was the extent of it. But at least it looks magnificent, though.
It does.
Yeah, I think that's the real winner here.
So what's the... How did Pretty Boy end up in the Chaos Realm?
Oh, well, basically, he lived...
He doesn't strike me as the type, you know? Like, to be too far away from the shopping mall?
Yeah, I think so. Wait, he ended up, like, killing his own dad. And then he got banished by his own people. And then that's how we ended up with Slaanesh. He's like the god of excess.
That makes sense.
Yeah, and then he gave him that special armor that keeps him that keeps dirt from getting on him. And he also gave him the ability that he can actually hover above ground, so he'll never have to get dirty in his life. Yeah.
That sounds magnificent.
It's very magnificent.
Hey, how come he doesn't hover in the game?
That's what I'm saying. He should at least hover a little bit.
You know how, like, Palpatine kind of hovered around everywhere in Battlefront? It needs to be like that.
Exactly. Make him as fast as a horse, maybe. That would be awesome. Alright, well, let's see. What other kind of matchups can we do? Oh, we haven't tried the Empire Amber guy yet.
Should we do an Amber Wizard?
Yeah. Let's see. Who would be a good counter for him? Maybe a Vampire, maybe?
I don't know. Let me see what his spells are good at. Let's see what all items he can get. So, what? You can put the Amber Wizard on an Imperial Griffin?
Oh, sweet. Let me see that.
No way.
That'd be awesome. He's expensive as hell, though. He's almost like freaking Carl Franz.
He doesn't have any items that you can put on him.
He's just a beast man in disguise.
He's 2230 if you pimp him all the way out.
Jeez.
Increased power reserves, increased power reserves.
So what does he have? Does he have magic missiles here?
He's got Blood Roar.
What does that do?
It's the ability that Franz usually has, that you can scare like enemy units when you charge in with the Griffin.
Oh, that makes sense. Because he channels the inner beast, I think.
Guess so. That's pretty crazy, though. Oh, I guess, I mean, yeah, since Amber's focused around like the whole... beast thing.
Yeah.
You think he's like Radagast the Brown?
Is that a unit?
No, from like Lord of the Rings.
Oh yeah, sorry. Prince. That's my lack of Lord of the Rings.
He has a bunch of bird dew on his head.
So yeah, you have a magic missile, the Amber Spear.
Yeah, I'm sitting here. I'm looking at the lore real quick. So yeah.
Oh, but that spear, that magic missile of yours causes damage to friendly combatants, though.
Does it?
Yeah.
That sounds nasty.
That would suck.
Can cause damage to friendly... Oh, I guess if you fired into the middle of them, maybe?
Yeah.
Oh, it's armor piercing, though.
I wonder if you could take on a light
effective
wizard.
At all ranges. And if you upgrade it, it does even more armor piercing damage and armor piercing explosion damage?
Holy smokes.
Dude, grab like a... Who are you gonna bring? Were you gonna bring vampires?
I'll think in a light wizard, but you think a vampire would be better?
Well, yeah, let's go head-to-head with the light wizard.
Okay.
Let's see who's boss.
Alright, do you wanna max everything out?
Yeah, I've got everything maxed out. All on right. The Amber Wizard. I'm just gonna leave my general sitting in the back.
Okay,
Dude, that upgraded spear missile looks pretty ridiculous.
Alright, I'm turning on my scrolls, too. Oh, nice. Scroll of leeching.
What? For the light wizard?
Yeah, it's got greatly reduced power recharge rate. And other things look pretty okay. Oh, what's this? Ability recharge in seconds for scroll of power. Alright. Alright, cool. I am ready.
Do it. Amber wizard.
This could be a magical duel, guys, for the ages. Harry Potter's got nothing on this.
Harry Potter's got nothing.
That's right, guys.
Someone needs to mod in Harry Potter now, too.
That would be so OP. Like, he has the ability the spell of love, and it deflects everything.
Spell of love.
He says,
my mom loved me.
She loved me. I'm the boy who lived.
I'm the boy who loved.
The boy. You have like the Marauder map scroll, which you can see everything.
Marauder map. No, yeah, that'd be pretty sick.
That'd be pretty badass. Let me see. So I'm pretty much going to be concentrating on Shem's burning glaze. Sorry, burning gaze, sorry.
I like glaze, though. It makes it sound like a donut.
I think it does. I can glaze.
Dude, they're going to totally pick that up at Krispy Kreme.
Yeah.
Part of the Creative Assembly to work with them on that. They'll make like a Shem's burning glazed.
This is part of our Warhammer promotion, guys. One of our own wizards is going to personally glaze your donut. Wink, wink.
I'm not going to lie. That griffin's looking pretty cool.
Oh, hold on.
Look at it. It's got like all the green feathers up front.
Oh, good lord. I bet you the guy would tear me up in a melee fight.
Probably. He's looking pretty good.
He's green. What the hell? Looks like a parrot. So, like, if magic wasn't your strong suit, you could just charge my guy, I think. But I will have the speed edge.
He has 450 weapon strength.
Jeez.
And 290 of its armor piercing with the griffin.
Mine's 300 weapon strength.
Wow, man. That makes this guy kind of a nice, like, cross-functional type. Like, not against other lords, I'm guessing, but, you know, like, into the back of infantry or something. He's going to be brutal.
Yeah. That'd be good against vampires.
Let's see if we can dodge the burning gaze. Dodge it! Dodge
let's see
it!
Let's see it! Oh, he dodged it! It must have been that green camouflage you're wearing.
All right. Should we give him the spear or the upgraded spear? Let's do the upgraded spear.
Alright, I'm gonna use my Scroll of Leech to get my abilities back faster. Uh-oh, what is
that? That looks like the Luminarch.
Whoa! Man, I'm glad I freaking missed that.
It takes a lot of magic, though, and I upgraded it was 15 or 14 magic or something.
Oh, really?
Oh!
Oh,
wow.
That was strong!
Dude, that iced him. The thing is your guy's faster. I don't think I can catch him.
Yeah, if he could, though, he would totally destroy me.
I shouldn't have tried the upgraded spell. Jeez, man! The cooldown on that Amber Spear was 45, like almost 50 seconds.
Holy smokes, dude. So you can't do anything right now, can you?
No. It's bone.
Alright, it's time to do some glazing again.
No.
Oh, gosh.
Dude, Shem's Burning Gaze is so good against, like, low armor units.
Yeah.
That's it.
Is that it? Is he gone?
Yeah, here. Let's do one. Like, bring some, I'm trying to think of a good unit to test him against.
Hey, how about Mannfred versus him?
Yeah, dude, put, like, Mannfred up on a zombie dragon. Let's see if we can hit him with that burning gaze. Or let's just, like, don't try and dodge it. Let's see what that upgraded spear does.
Okay. Just sit there and take it. Let's see.
I kind of want to test it against a ground unit, too, and see if it does any good.
Okay, I can bring a ground unit, too.
Hey, I'm going to bring another, like, I'll bring two of the Amber Wizards.
All right.
And then we can maybe test it against Mannfred and then like bring like a Graveguard, like some with plenty of armor.
Graveguard? Okay. Let's see. Or I've got one of these Fargulfs. No.
Anything that's really high armor.
We'll try the Graveguard.
What's their armor rating?
It's 90 with a shield on it.
It's pretty good. It's pretty good.
Let's try the shielded one. Yeah. All right.
Okay, I've got two Amber Wizards so we can try. Right. I want to try it against a ground target, then one against the... We're going to have to wait for the Winds of Magic to build up, though, because it takes 14 winds to do the upgraded spear.
Okay. Are you going to attack Mannfred first, or the Grey Guard?
We can do it at the same time if we want to see what happens.
Okay. The lore of heavens.
I think the Arachnarok is pretty heavily armored, so that spear might be good against the Arachnarok spider.
Oh, yeah, we got to try that. I hunger. Let's see. I'm going to spread my guys out in a line. Do you want them next to each other?
You can spread them a little bit apart from each other so we don't have any misfires.
All right. I think it should be good enough right here.
We can fast forward for a minute. Just build up the reserves.
Okay.
Here we go.
So let me look at these amber guys again real quick. So we got fast forward motion here. That's why they're flapping so fast.
Hummingbird?
Yeah. Tweet, 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 tweet.
Let's see. I'm going to wait until we get up to 30 on the magic.
All right. At this, I want to see if how this guy would do in a melee fight against Mannfred, like after this scenario.
Sure.
Because I think this griffin's pretty damn baller.
let's Let's see. Okay, I should be able to do... Alright.
Got your spells?
I should be able. Yep.
Alright.
I'm going to move up just a little bit just to make sure that...
So the spell's called Ember Sphere?
Yeah, just stay completely stationary and let's just test the best...
Okay.
Best case scenario. Yeah, it's Ember Sphere. It has a 63-second cooldown.
Holy cow, man. Better make that shot count.
Spirit Leech is only 13 seconds, but...
Yeah, dude, Spirit Leech should be like 60 at least.
You would think, but... Alright, here's one coming towards Von Karstein. And I'm casting these from max range, so we'll see what happens.
I guess.
It's a pretty nasty looking spell.
Yeah. Freaking Photon Torpedo. Ooh, that didn't do too much damage.
No, that was not very impressive. Not for the price.
Yeah, maybe let's try a second shot.
That's... Yeah, I mean, that doesn't even seem very impressive.
Yeah. Try another one. Maybe get closer, see what happens.
Alright, I'm charging up the Winds of Magic again.
I know sometimes the first spell doesn't do too much damage. Well, sometimes it does, but... Alright, we're gonna watch these Ember Wizards.
I get 14. I'll take another shot at Von Karstein from close range.
Alright.
That was the upgraded one. Didn't seem to do a whole lot.
Here goes, guys. Get ready for
right,
this.
I gotta wait on this cooldown because it's forever long.
Gotcha.
Your reserve is gonna recharge well before you ever...
Exactly. I could just use my old invocation. Is it still charging?
No, I'm charged. There we go. I got the, I was waiting on the cooldown.
Damn, that would suck in a duel.
Yes.
Oh, that was better.
That was, yeah, quite a bit better. Here, check this special ability out. Let's wait for it.
What's the ability?
You'll see.
Uh-oh. Are you casting on Mannfred?
Kind of.
Okay.
Here, fast forward for a second.
Oh, sure. I feel like maybe the Ember Wizard might... I mean, depending on the situation, he might be better on something faster, but less powerful, maybe?
Yeah, maybe so. I don't know.
But that'd be cool,
like
though.
I said, he'd be good against infantry in a, in the end game or something, but...
Yeah. Yeah.
All right, here we go.
Yeah, maybe against the dwarves, he'd be pretty good on a griffin.
Oh, almost ready. Here, check out this trick.
All right, here we go. See what happens here. He's charging up. What the hell is this? What are these ghosts? What is that?
How about a feral manticore?
Oh, that's the manticore. Here, see if you can take my guy on.
Alright, I'm gonna see if we can, with the help of the manticore, see if we can take out Von Karstein right now.
I'm gonna countercharge him.
Well, of course, we did make... well, I mean, you could always use your invocation and stuff.
I'll do it real quick. Hold on. Let's see.
Or did you bring any of that stuff on him?
Yeah, I brought it.
Okay. Tag team.
Oh, damn. Mephrod's going down really fast.
Where's the folding chair?
Here comes guys. From behind. From the top. From the top bar or whatever. The top rope. Dude, I think even with... what do you call it? With,
did you get the cash invocation?
I thought I did, but I think even with invocation, I think he would have died. You want to try that? See,
Yeah, we can try it.
Let's try that.
See if the Ember Wizard can use the mana core to go melee.
Yeah. I think he might be able to. I didn't know about that. I know you
probably
told
have
me.
To run after this one.
Okay. I think we got plenty of good testing in, though.
It's been interesting stuff. This is going to at least, it's going to at least flip things on its head for a little while.
Yeah.
Going to have to develop a whole new meta game here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm definitely going to tink around with the, what do you call it, the Ember Wizards.
See, the Beastmen, though, it's a $17 DLC. I wonder how many people will or won't buy it.
I mean, as a fan, I would buy it.
See, I'm the same way. It's like, if I have a game I like and someone makes DLC, I'm going to buy it.
Yeah, regardless of, I'm just going to buy it.
Yeah, just because it's kind of like a collector's thing, right? You know, it's like, if they made something for like a, you know, like when I was a kid and had a toy and there's something, I want that.
Exactly. I don't care how much it costs. That's mine.
So it's like, I want it to be good, but you know, it's like, you know, it's just part of, you feel like you have an incomplete collection, I guess.
Yeah. Hey, I'm going to charge you. Do you think you can get out your mana core in time?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah,
yeah. Okay, I'm going right for you then.
Oh, yeah, you're good. Oh, I have a guy on the ground, though, and it's screwing you over.
Oh,
here, go back and bring a ground hit.
Oh, okay, my bad, sorry.
Just throw, like, a graveyard or something in there.
Yeah, I wasn't thinking.
It's gonna ruin your leadership.
Yeah. All right. Graveguards.
I only need one, so I'm gonna get rid of the one. There we go.
So, yeah, that way, I'm gonna fly right at him, and then we'll see if he can get his manicure out in time.
I think so. Try and heal and everything if you have to also, or Spirit Leech, whatever you think.
Okay.
See if you can find his way out of it.
I might try the missile, maybe. I don't know.
Being able to spawn a Manticore, dude, that's pretty legit.
That is pretty awesome.
That might make it worth the cost, like especially since you can just like ditch every other ability with the Ember Wizard, stick him on a Griffin, and then spawn a Manticore.
Yeah.
That'd be like two flying units for the cost of one.
That is a sweet deal. Kind of like Malagor's Saigor. I think the Saigor would be really great against Dwarves players, maybe.
Oh, yeah, it'd be pretty good.
So let's get my Spirit Leech ready here.
Okay.
Alright, there he is. That's my target, guys.
It only takes 16 mana to...
Oh, that's it?
Yeah, it's the same as a Saigor.
Okay,
16 mana.
It's a one-time deal, though?
Yeah, one-time deal.
You better watch out, man. I got Spirit Leech coming for you. Get ready for it. Maybe you should Spirit Leech your Manticore. Let's try to ignore your Manticore. Let's see if that helps. My lord is under attack. Holy cow, that thing is strong.
So the Manticore is 430 weapon strength.
Damn.
145 armor piercing. It doesn't have much armor, but it's got some pretty serious weapon strength.
Yeah. I don't know what's causing more damage, your Griffin or your Manticore.
The Griffin's pretty good anti-air, you know, like some it's...
Well, at least I got rid of that guy. Let's see if that helps. They can cast a invocation.
If you kill... I mean, here's a thought, though, to you. Like, I wonder if you kill the wizard that spawned the thing, whether it should take that unit out too, or if that would be... Maybe that would be the balance for the fact that the price could be so much less. Like, I don't have to pay for a Manticore, you know?
Maybe. Or I feel like if they summon it, they took it out from another dimension or another area.
Maybe so.
Yeah.
It's not like a necromancer or something. It's like holding the stuff together.
Exactly. Dude, that was pretty awesome.
Dude. Manticore.
That was badass. I'm about to use those guys.
Because, an interesting combo.
Yeah. Oh, sweet, man. Well, thanks for helping out, man.
Yeah, it's fun.
Yeah,
got to learn some stuff.
Yeah, any closing thoughts?
Spawning monsters for the win.
Yes.
I think that's where it's going to be at.
It's going to be the new meta, guys.
I mean, and don't get me wrong, it's not like the vampires need anything else, but, you know, them spawning a unit of skeletons or zombies is going to look pretty pale in comparison there.
Oh, hell yeah.
And I'm pretty sure the dwarves are still going to stink.
I think so.
I mean, a little better, but we'll see.
Slightly better.
All right, we'll see you later.
All right, thanks, Air.
See ya.
See ya.